In this video, we will use area to discover the distributive property. Linda has a rectangular flower bed that is 10 feet long and 4 feet wide, as shown here. She is going to plant morning glories and tulips. She wants more morning glories than tulips and decides to divide the garden as shown below. Notice how the part of the garden for morning glories has dimensions 7 feet by 4 feet, and the part of the garden for the tulips has dimensions 4 feet by 3 feet. We know this length is 4 feet because the opposite side also has a length of 4 feet. For A, determine the total area of the garden by multiplying the total length and width. Remember, the area of a rectangle is equal to length times width, which means the area of the entire garden A is equal to 10 feet times 4 feet. Ten times four is 40, and feet times feet gives us square feet. The area is equal to 40 square feet, which means 40 1 foot by 1 foot squares will fit inside the entire garden. For part B, determine the total number of square feet or area that will be planted with tulips. Show what quantities you multiply. The dimensions of the part of the garden for tulips is 4 feet by 3 feet, which means the area of the tulip part of the garden, which we'll call A sub T, T for tulips, is equal to 4 feet times 3 feet, which equals 12 square feet. For part D, determine the total number of square feet or area they'll be planted with morning glories. Again, show the quantities multiplied. Let's call the area of the morning glory part of the garden A sub M, M for morning glories. The dimensions of the morning glory part of the garden are 7 feet by 4 feet, which means the area of the morning glory part of the garden is 7 feet times 4 feet. 7 times 4 equals 28. The area is 28 square feet. For part D, determine the total area of the garden by adding the area planted with tulips and the area planted with morning glories. Remember, we already found the total area in part A by multiplying the length and the width of the entire garden. But for part D, they're asking us to find the total area by summing the two smaller areas. So the total area A is equal to 12 feet squared plus 28 feet squared, which again does give us 40 square feet. For part E, using the equation below, describe in words how it represents the two ways we found the total area of the garden. This relationship is called the distributive property. So this equation is telling us the expression 4 times 3 plus 4 times 7 equals the expression 4 times the quantity 3 plus 7. Looking at the product 4 times 3, notice how 4 times 3 gave us the area of the part of the garden for tulips. So this product represents A sub T plus 4 times 7 is equal to 7 times 4 using the commutative property multiplication. And notice 7 times 4 gave us the area of the morning glory part of the garden. So 4 times 7 is equal to A sub M. And now on the right side of the equation, notice if we use the order of operations and simplify inside the parentheses, 3 plus 7 is 10. So we have the product of 4 and 10 here, which is equivalent to 10 times 4, which is the product that gave us the total area of the garden. So the right side of the equation is equal to A, and we know the left side is equal to the right side, which does verify these two expressions are equivalent or equal to each other, which is the distributive property. Often the distributive property is called multiplication over addition or over subtraction. Let's look at some examples. These first two demonstrate distribution or multiplication over addition. I've shown this two ways because sometimes we will see a multiplication sign here and sometimes we won't. Either way, to clear the parentheses, we can distribute the 4, which gives us 4 times 3 plus 4 times 7. And we often use arrows as shown here to model distribution. Similarly, we can distribute over subtraction. To clear the parentheses here, we distribute 3, which gives us 3 times 6 minus 3 times 4. I hope you found this helpful.